Hello again, this is PC Delta Link, back with more of our Enigmatica 2 Let's Play Normal Mode, and this is episode 81. Alright, we're still over here in our Astral Sorcery area, because we have a lot we're going to try to do today. You might remember, for one, that last episode we had tried to make the... Observatory right here. But I had forgotten the fact that I didn't have any crystals attuned to Lucerna. I have gone through and fixed this problem. There's this chest here next to the attunement altar. I now have all of the major constellations. There's Armara, Dissidia, Evitas, Evorcio, and Vicio. All those are attuned. And then the minor constellations I now have attuned. We have Mineralis, Boetus, however it is, Pelotrio, Lucerna, Octans, and Fornax. So we have all crystals attuned to those, so we can use them for crafting as needed. The constellation pair in here, the Horologium, Altaria, Alcara, Gelu, and Borux, those are the constellations I do not have yet in crystal form. They have not shown up in the night sky, and I believe that's because I need the observatory to be able to craft those. So something else I want to show you guys. I don't think I ever covered this before, but something very unique about these celestial gateways is that they can... Here's the new one. Let's go to this one. I don't think I ever mentioned this before, but celestial gateways can cross dimensions. So I put one in the end over here, just to show that it can be done. So yeah, you can use celestial gateways if you need to warp between dimensions. And also, I went on a bit of an Enderman killing spree while I was down there. Well, there and also at my spawner over there. And we picked up just a few drops from Enderman. I enchanted my Draconic Sword with Looting 3. Using our little enchanter that we've used this before. We use this, I think, to get our bow infinity and other stuff like that. But yeah, I use it to put Looting 3 on our Draconic Sword, because this thing one-shots Enderman and it hits multiple Endermen. So yeah, we have quite a bit of Ender Pearls now. I'm not at all worried about those anymore. For a while, we were pretty much out of Ender Pearls, you might recall. And we have more solidified experience if for some reason I need more XP. It's funny that out of all the Endermen we killed, though, with, you know, the equivalent of Fortune 3 on there, we only got 2 Dimlet Parcels and 1 Enderman Soul from Draconic Evolution. Dimlet Parcels are used for RF Tool Dimensions, which we'll get into those in a later episode. But it's basically a mod that lets you create your own dimensions to use for collecting various materials. Like, you could use it to create a dimension that's all iron ore blocks, and you can literally have a dimension full of iron ore that could give you all the resources you could ever need. Now, granted, at this point you probably had drills, but it's still kind of cool. Okay, I'm sorry, I had to take a drink there. Okay. So let's see here. I feel like there was something else I needed to mention. Yes. So let me head back over to the altar over there. There we go. So remember, I had tried to make the containment chalice and use it for helping out our Starlight Infuser, and it didn't work, and I said it was probably something I screwed up on. It was something I screwed up on. I didn't have it close enough. I was always unsure of, like, what you can actually have in or on these structures that... how do I word this? I was afraid to put it any closer because I didn't know if it would interfere with this being a complete structure if you started placing blocks in it. But it does not. So now if we place something on here and we try to enchant it, you'll see the starlight actually coming from the block there instead. Oh, and you see it did use a little bit. Now, here's the cool thing. So normally, when this actually uses up starlight, you know, it uses up a whole bucket. You have to get a bucket out of there or out of your container or whatever and place it back down here. This actually can give you a discount. So if you look at the number at the top of the screen, the liquid starlight, we did not use a full bucket there. We only used 400 millibuckets. So not only will this automatically fill any starlight that's used up, but it does so at a discount. So that's really freaking cool. Also, something else, I was kind of afraid to move it, because if you just mine this with a pickaxe, you will lose whatever starlight is in it. However, I'm happy to say that cardboard boxes move them just fine without any loss of starlight. So that's really cool and just shows how, again, overpowered cardboard boxes are. Oh, there it is. So, okay, let me get this. Also, from farming the Enderman, we did manage to get a couple more perk levels. So let's run into our perk tree here. We're actually almost level 9. So we're going to go over this way, increased effectiveness of perks, and then we're going to do increased perk experience. I don't think I need perk effectiveness right now. We're going to head up this way, up the tree, because I want this Calling Strike one eventually, I think. Or at the very least, I'd like to get this Epiphany node, because I don't know what these Epiphany nodes do. So, I don't know, it'd just be kind of something neat to see. So yeah, we're going to head toward Calling Strike and this Epiphany node. So let's go ahead and, how many points? I got 2 points left. Let's just go ahead and head up this way, right up the tree. Okay, so that'll be it for now in the tree, but we're getting there. We're getting some advancement. I don't remember the max level this tree goes to. I want to say level 20 is as high as you can get, but I'm not 100% sure on that. Don't quote me. Okay, so first thing, let's go finish the crafting that we were going to do last episode. And let's go ahead and get our observatory. Now you can see this requires quite a few items, some of which we've never made them before, like this infused glass, for example. We've never made this before. So this is used mainly on a different system that we haven't gotten into yet. Let me, which chapter is that in? Here it is. That glass is usually used on the stellar refraction table, which this is used for, here's the recipe, mainly for in either enchanting or for alchemy, potion making. I've really never been a big user of potions in Minecraft, so I know they can be really powerful, but I've just never really spent much time on them. So that's why we've never really covered the stellar refraction table yet. We probably will at some point, but just, yeah, not any time recently. So, all right, we're going to need one of these spectral lenses. So this just takes any colored lens, 2 glass lenses, then 4 stardust and 4 resonating gems. So that's not too expensive. And we'll just use up one of our lenses here because, hey, it's not like this is working anyway. We can't get our colored lenses to do anything as it is. Okay, 4 stardust. Yeah, 4 resonating gems. Okay. And I already forgot the recipe, because of course I did. Okay, resonating in the corners, and then the stardust right below that. Come on, there we go. I'll just put this like so. There we go. Should only take a moment to make this. There we go. Infused glass. So, all right, let's look and see what else we need for our observatory here. So we have the infused glass, 6 ruined marble, 4 gold nuggets, 2 lenses, 4 gold bars. You can see we got all this right here. 2 stardust. Stardust? We need stardust? Oh, yeah, we do. Okay, for outside the table. 6 rune, 4 nuggets, 4 gold, 2 lenses. I'll go ahead and grab all this out of the table. 4 illumination powder, and then we need something that we have not made before, which is nocturnal powder. Now, this stuff is used to basically do the opposite of the illumination powder. This will make things dark where it's placed, and it can allow for mobs to spawn it. So, yeah, very handy with that. So this just requires some black dye of some kind, ink sac works, 2 coal, illumination powder, and a lapis lazuli. So definitely not an expensive recipe at all. So we're just going to grab that, we're going to grab 2 coal, and we're going to grab an ink sac. Oh, come on now. Okay, we're going to need 1 more illumination powder. Okay, there's our nocturnal powder. Okay, so now let's get the telescope recipe going here. And this is a observatory recipe going. So infused glass, 6 ruined marble. Right. I did that wrong. Yeah, that's the gold nuggets. My bad. Gold nuggets. Yeah, gold bars. Okay, and then we just need the 4 illumination powder, 2 nocturnal powder, and 2 stardust for the 8 crafting spots around the table. So let me go ahead and get those on the hot bar down here so we have them ready to go. And last thing we need, of course, is our Lucerna crystal. So let's find that one. Here it is, Lucerna. Oh. And we'll go ahead and drop this in the table. And you see, there's our observatory. And of course, the Lucerna pattern is... I want it to be night for this, because we're going to want to use this anyway and try to see how it works and if we can find some of the constellations that we're missing. So I'm going to go ahead and set it to nightfall real quick. Okay, there we go. Go ahead and leave 2 of the nocturnal powder in here because I only need 2 for this recipe. There you go. You can see the constellation a lot better now on the radiant altar here. So, okay, let's go ahead and craft the observatory. I've been waiting for this for a long time. Just gotta wait for it to ask for the, okay, illumination powder. Stardust. Illumination powder. Nocturnal powder. Illumination powder. Stardust. Illumination powder, and then we have our nocturnal powder for last. There we go. That looks so cool. Little lightning bolts hitting it too. Okay, we have an observatory. I also made this platform a little bit bigger in anticipation of that. Oh, right. This thing does not really get dug out with a pickaxe. I mean, look at this. Yeah, pickaxe does not do well in that. So we have our hatchet with us to deal with this. There we go. Okay. I have no idea how big this is. Oh, pretty good size. Okay. Oh, that looks awesome, though. Okay, how does this... Oh, you can just rotate. We can't really do... You can go up and down, but not by much. Okay. Oh, there's a constellation right there. And it's got to be one of the ones we're missing, because there's not many of those at this point. Okay, let me... I was in the chair of it, actually, like a minecart. Okay, let me grab our constellation papers. Oh, right there. That's 6 stars. So let me... Nope, not that one. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Nope, not that one. Gelu. Maybe Gelu. Let me take a look. So 3 toward the middle, and then the other ones... That might be Gelu. Okay. Let me try it. Yep, we got it. Gelu. See if there's any other ones tonight. Doesn't look... Oh, never mind. Forget what I said. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Another one with 6. So we have Gelu now. Alkara? What's Alkara? 3... Oh, it might be Alkara. So a little triangle. Oh gosh. Okay. I think I can do this real quick. Get that one up here, and then like this, and like that. Got Alkara. Okay, that's probably those two for tonight now. What we're going to want to do real quick is get our spectral relays here. And we're going to want to get crystals on these real quick so that we have them in our crafting table if we need them. So if we move quick, we should be able to get both of these tonight. Okay, grab me your rock crystal quickly. Sure, that's fine. Did I miss? Can you not attune crystals to that? You should be able to, I would think. Does it need more power or something? Can I link it to... No, you can't. Well, you have to be able to do something with these minor constellations, don't you? Like, let me find... Let's look at Alkara. Yeah, faint, ritual trait. Well, in order to have a ritual, you have to have a crystal attuned to it. I noticed you can't put it on a, you can't put it on the... Mantle of the Stars. It's not strong enough for that, it doesn't look like. But, yeah, we should be able to... Does it have to be a celestial crystal? So, and I do have a celestial crystal here that's empty. Let me try that one. Oh, if I can get on the altar. No. That's really strange. I'm not sure what you're supposed to do then to, in order to get these to be attuned on various crystals. Huh. Well, okay. Well, in between episodes, we'll end up working on getting more of these minor constellations done. Where's Alcara's done? Well, no, it's not done because I don't have anything for it. So we'll still hang on to both of these for now. All right, let me head back to base and get rid of the rain, among other things. Okay. Stop the rain. Okay, well, we got the observatory, and now, as you see, we can find those constellations that we're missing. I think real quick, I'd like to build the advanced sextant so that we can use it for its higher properties. I'm not sure exactly what this does, but this is something I've just been meaning to craft for a while. I've just never gotten to it yet. We're gonna need 2 spectral lenses for this. So that's 4 stardust. So all right, 8 stardust, 4 gems, 4 illumination powder, 2 lenses. Okay. We'll just make this right here. Hopefully we'll have enough starlight to get it all. There we go, got it all. I actually ended up crafting a lot more of that than I thought I would get, but that's alright. We can always use more of that later. Alright, we're gonna need some glass lenses, so we'll take some of these with us. We're gonna need 4 sticks, it looks like. And it did require one of the infused wood, vibrant infused wood, so let's see. Oh, we just infuse it on the starlight altar, it looks like. So let's find our infused wood. Here we go. So let's take 2 of those with us. All right, and just for the... Well, it doesn't matter. We have enough starlight there. Okay, let's go ahead and grab some of the infused glass. This is so nice that basically you can just do this super quick now and not ever have to worry about the pool around the altar running out because of having the containment chalice providing extra starlight as needed. We'll go ahead and do all these real quick, because this is actually going really quick. Because we'll end up needing these lenses for something else later, I'm sure. Okay, and then we need our infused wood. Yep, there you go. That's all you do to get vibrant infused wood. So I wonder if this stuff glows. Or if it just looks different. Well, that would be a test that would require nightfall for me to check that real quick. So let me go ahead and skip it to moonrise. There it goes. Bye, little sun. No, it is not a light source. Okay, that's fine. I just wanted to check, since it had the name Vibrant, I wasn't 100% sure. Okay, so let me look at this one more time. Oh yeah, we need our 2 spectral lenses. So alright, let's do that first. So we need our 4 resonating gems. Stardust in all the corners. Some illumination powder, and then... Two lenses. Now, you see, we still have our crystal in here for Lucerna. Those can stay in here as long as they don't, like, you know, they don't really interfere with crafting. So you can leave them in the table if you want to. Don't know what that was right then. Okay, so we got both of our colored lenses, spectral. These lenses... where's our crystal prism? I can check if this will work real quick, or at least it'll let me show it to you guys. I doubt it, but I can try. So, alright, let me get our... Oh, wrong tool. Link that up to the prism. So how the spectral lens normally is used, you know, we've had issues with our lenses not working properly. But normally, let me go and link it to this block. Should be a lovely purple, yes. Normally, the spectral lens will go through objects, and it looks like this might be working. Because, like, if I have a different lens... Yeah, so you see the red lens, the damaged lens, does not link to the block properly, while the spectral lens does. The spectral lens allows you to go through walls, through multiple blocks. I think it can go to multiple blocks, actually, if it wants to, or needs to. Let me go ahead and throw a second one down. Yeah, it can. Now, you do lose a little bit of the power of the starlight when you do this. I don't know if it's per block or if it's distance. It's probably per block it has to go through. But yeah, you do have slight diminishing returns. You do notice the beam is a lot more vibrant right here, and it is slightly dimmer looking over here. But if I... Yeah, and see, it gets dimmer as well if you add more blocks to it. So yeah, it's a little bit brighter now. So yeah. So that one actually does appear to be working properly. So, all right, let's go ahead and grab our advanced sextant. Yeah, I had the regular one. We're going to need our book again. 4-star metal. Oh, I don't have star metal. Yeah, I do. That's in the middle, isn't it? No, one above. Okay. This goes here, or two vibrant would go here. And our star metal, is it, well, like that? Nope, one above. Okay, resonating gems. Eh, close. Okay, there we go. Let's go ahead and craft that. Okay. So let's... Oh, so it can find more things. So, yeah, we had... Before we had our ancient shrine, the desert shrine, and the small shrine, but now we have it can seek out villages, temples, ocean monuments, which is nice. Hell Fortress. It's called Nether Fortress. I don't know why it's called Hell Fortress here. End cities, okay. Oh, you can use it for different biomes even. Forest, cold, jungle, mesa, ocean, mountains. Cool! So you can see, yeah, there's a lot more just right here. There's a lot more colored stars in the sky now that you can use with the advanced sextant to find them. So that's really nifty. Okay, cool. All right, what's our time at? Oh, we are basically out of time. So, all right, next episode, I am planning to go into rituals. I know that's something that's been available for ages, but until you had your crystals attuned to the various constellations, you really couldn't do much of them. So, Now that we do have all those crystals, though, attuned to the constellations, I can show off rituals. So we'll be doing that next episode. The other thing I need to mention that I thought about the other day, I don't have a decision on when I'm going to next do a world upload, probably after next episode. But I thought about something the other day, and that's your progress in mods like Astral Sorcery, you know, for all your research trees, and then Thaumcraft are tied to your individual character. They are not tied to the world save. So, like, whoever, if any of you downloaded the world and then went to do something with Thaumcraft, you wouldn't be able to do anything. So, there are two things that we have. Oh, one of them's over there. That can let us mitigate that somewhat. And here it is. This is the Scroll of Written Expertise. And you see it says, contains knowledge from Vendable Sheik, which is my character on here. So, this will let anyone who has this, basically, I'm assuming you just right-click it, and you'll take all the research and knowledge that I've done in Astral Sorcery. And the same thing with Thaumcraft, you have the Tome of Knowledge Sharing, and see Bound to Vendable Sheik's Research. So this will unlock all of the stuff in Thaumcraft that I've done for you guys as well. Now for the Thaumcraft one, that was a little bit harder, because I need the, I haven't been over here in ages. Oh, jeez. Give me that. Where? Here it is. Thaumonomicon. So, in our Thaumonomicon, over in, here it is, the Thaumic Tinker page, the Tome of Knowledge Sharing is actually here. And, you know, it says I haven't begun this research, because this is one of those that doesn't complete. It's glitched out for some reason. I just hit complete, and nothing ever happens. It never finishes. It never does anything. So, I did end up using creative mode to spawn in that Tome of Knowledge Sharing, so you guys have access to the research. Because otherwise, you all would have to do everything from scratch. And I don't know why it's glitched. I don't know why. And really, it's this entire tree. None of this tree works properly. Any of the Thaumic Tinker page does not seem to be working, no matter what I've tried. So, yeah, really unfortunate, but yeah, at least you guys have it, so. So yeah, and Batania, I don't remember if Batania has anything like that or not. I think Batania is not really, there's not really research per se in Batania, it's just if you have the Lexica Batania, you have everything, you know what I mean? But I might see if there's, I might look at that book and see if there's a copy thing you need to do for that as well. But I think that we're good, so those two books will be in here in the inventory chest. So next time the world is downloaded, or uploaded, I should say, you guys can find those research for Astral Sorcery and Thaumcraft in this chest so that you guys can have all the work I've done in those magic mods. So alright, that's going to be it for today. So thank you all very much for watching. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you all next time.